Hey everyone, hope you're having an amazing day. It's Tom. Today's episode name is Antarctic Secrets Hidden Under Ice. Did you know that Antarctica was once without ice and covered with vegetation with temperatures around 15 degrees Celsius? Basically, it was a jungle with huge trees, and it was full of life. Today, petrified remnants of trees and fossils of marine animals, birds, and dinosaurs from the Cretaceous period are abundant in Antarctica. What could have been in this place before it was covered by ice and snow? No one knows exactly, because it is really difficult for scientists to get to the evidence here. However, some people think that a long-lost civilization could be hidden here, and it is only a matter of time before more ice melts and the buildings and everything left behind may appear again. Do you think this is an exaggerated theory without evidence? Well, let's take a look at some interesting information about this place. Maybe we'll give this theory a chance. Antarctica is a desolate, icy desert with strong winds and the lowest temperatures on Earth. The coldest recorded temperature was -89.4 degrees centigrade, and yet it is also home to countless unique wild animals. It was previously thought that nothing could survive under massive ice sheets, but scientists have discovered a number of unusual species that have adapted to harsh environments. There are microbes, crustaceans, colossal octopuses, long-legged spiders the size of plates, giant worms with shiny golden bristles, and a large jaw with sharp teeth. You can even find transparent fish. These strange creatures have large eyes, and their internal organs are visible through their translucent skin. Fish have antifreeze glycoproteins and cannot survive in warmer waters. Probably one of the most fundamental reasons is its isolation. You can't just go on a trip there these days. Moreover, although we have only officially known about Antarctica for 200 years, there are old maps that show Antarctica without ice cover. One of the undoubtedly most controversial maps was created in 1513 by Turkish Admiral Piri Reise. He created a map and drew it on a piece of gazelle skin, which almost 500 years later started a worldwide debate. This map shows part of the coast and inland of Antarctica completely without ice. Thanks to the amazing accuracy of the Piri Reise map, scholars have been shaking their heads since the continent of Antarctica was discovered in 1818, 300 years after the map was drawn. Nevertheless, it shows the mainland where Antarctica is, and it is absolutely without ice. How is this possible, given the limitations of geodetic facilities in 1500? One theory is that the map was drawn using information on much older maps that were created so long ago that it was before Antarctica was covered in ice. If so, it is evidence of an advanced and much older civilization that preceded known civilizations, and it accurately recorded this map. The history of Antarctica begins with the ancient inhabitants of America, who spoke of a huge land known as Terra Australis, which was supposed to be located far to the south of the globe. By the way, you can look forward to it now, because this map and the information on it are so amazing that I will make a video about it soon. But let's now look at other interesting discoveries from recent times. Antarctica has always been considered one of the most mysterious places on Earth. Ever since World War II, people have believed that Antarctica is one of the most guarded places in the world for a good reason, but only a select few know it. Many writers and researchers claim that there are many very interesting things hidden under the ice in Antarctica that are deliberately hidden from people. When you think of Antarctica, you usually don't think of weather and a t-shirt, but that's exactly the area scientists have found in the middle of the tundra. Mount Erebus is an extreme natural wonder, with liquid magma and ancient lava lakes that have been boiling for about 1.3 million years. It is the southernmost active volcano in the world, and the second highest volcano in Antarctica, which rises to a height of 3,800 meters. Scientists at the top found organisms living in the heat of the volcano. The researchers also discovered a network of hidden ice caves below Mount Erebus on Ross Island. In this oasis, the air temperature is around 25 degrees centigrade. The heat of the volcano combined with the temperatures below the continent's freezing point created surprisingly pleasant conditions, as in a large igloo. One could have a t-shirt here, and it wouldn't be cold, said Chief Researcher Sarah Wynne Fraser. Near the entrance to the cave is a light that penetrates deeper into some caves, where there is thin ice. Fraser and her team from the Australian National University conducted forensic studies of the soil in the cave. Studies have revealed DNA evidence of algae, moss, and even small animals. Although scientists have not seen life forms in person, they believe the findings signal a larger ecosystem thriving somewhere on the continent, and said they may be completely unknown species we know nothing about. Some specimens looked like they came from some kind of arthropod, and arthropods are things like spiders, mites, or insects. The next step in the research will be to involve biologists looking for animals that scientists think could live deeper down there. Caves in Antarctica are known to be home to various bacterial and fungal communities, so it would make sense for higher-level creatures to live there. In addition, cave systems have not yet been fully explored, and a team of researchers is working to develop a 3D model of the interaction of Mount Erebus from its source to its surface. This would help researchers find more caves and paths to them. Scientists have discovered a gigantic cavity that formed in the Thwaites Glacier in West Antarctica. The massive cave is about 45 km2, as big as a district town, and its height reaches up to 300 meters. The discovery is part of a glacier study conducted under the auspices of NASA, and therefore the information that will be published will be approved by the government. The experts working on the project expected to find gaps between the ice and the subsoil, through which ocean water can flow, and it melts the glacier from below. Eric Rignett of the University of California and co-author of a new study published today in the journal Science Advances said, I quote, "Thanks to the new generation of satellites, we can finally see the details and the size of the space between ice and land. According to calculations, up to 14 billion tons of ice would normally fit in the empty cavity." Unquote. The new data comes from the latest generation of ice radars used during NASA's Operation Icebridge. The aim of the project is to compile a three-dimensional map of Antarctica. With the help of aircraft with a special radar, it is possible to examine the glacier up to the subsoil itself. A hidden heat source has been found to melt a glacier from below in Antarctica. Is it hiding in these huge cavities with fresh water and heat that can reach plus 25 degrees centigrade? If there is nothing there, I can promise you that we will find out, and if there is something interesting there, I can also promise you that we will not know. Today, it is already known that there are lakes hidden in the dark under glaciers in Antarctica. They are under hundreds or even thousands of meters of ice. Scientists believe that it was formed by melting caused by the pressure of a strong ice sheet and volcanic activity heating the land under ice. About 400 such lakes are scattered in Antarctica. In 2013, wizard scientists drilled Whillans Lake under the ice of West Antarctica using a hot water drilling system. They melted a hole about 60 centimeters in diameter and almost 800 meters deep and took samples. Lake Whillans is part of an interconnected network of lakes that flows into the ocean in the Ross Sea shelf. When the team analyzed samples taken from the lake, they surprisingly found that it was rich in microbial life, fungi and other smaller animals. Another such place is the huge Lake Vostok in East Antarctica near the Russian research station Vostok. The lake is closed from the rest of the world, hidden under 4 kilometers of ice. But once this lake was not under ice and existed here in the time of the dinosaurs. What unique life forms could have evolved in the hidden depths, or what dinosaur times could have survived here? After 10 years, the Russian drill finally came under the glacier. Lake Vostok is one of the largest on the planet and covers an area of 10,000 square kilometers. The lake is 250 kilometers long, 50 kilometers wide, and is isolated from other lakes found in Antarctica. Scientists assume that everything that lives in the lake is either a very old or a potentially unknown form of life. First, scientists identified thousands of bacteria from the first samples, including those commonly found in the digestive system of fish, crustaceans, and worms. They discovered organisms that live in extreme cold, but more interestingly, they also found thermophilic organisms, which proves the presence of hot water vents deep in the lake. The measured water temperature was 16 degrees centigrade, and this means that it is suitable for the life of both small and large forms of life. However, thousands of life forms were gradually discovered in that underground freshwater lake, most of them unlike anything seen elsewhere on Earth. This includes several species of crustaceans, a new species of tardigrade, sometimes called water bears, and even fish. Lake Vostok is estimated to be at least 13 million years old, and scientists are wondering how this life could have existed in isolation from other creatures on the planet. For now, however, the priority is to continue research and unlock more secrets about Lake Vostok. Given that Antarctica was responsible for some of the most interesting geographic images taken recently, there is a good chance that what else emerges from this mysterious water will be just as stunning. Another attraction is the Ross Ice Shelf, which is the largest ice shelf in Antarctica. It is several hundred meters thick and covers an area of over 500,000 square kilometers, about the same as France. This shelf sings a scary melody, and scientists think it is caused by the winds that blow through the snow dunes. Continuous seismic tones are not audible to human ears, and scientists use seismic sensors to listen to mournful melodies. Listen for yourself how the tones sound. Thanks for watching this video, and if you like it, please remember to give it thumbs up. Leave comment below, I'd love to read from you, and if you're not subscribed, click subscribe, and also click the little bell icon, so you'll immediately get notified of the next video that I publish. Thanks again for watching, and I will see you on the next video.